Hello and welcome. It feels almost like it was yesterday that I could rely on my trusty PlayStation Portable to go online and do almost anything I needed that wasn't streaming video. I could share levels on Little Big Planet, Google a puzzling question, send a hilarious email, or just looking up the latest news about the newest upcoming games on the PlayStation Network. However, trying to do any of this nowadays is nearly impossible, since I can't even connect my PSP to a Wi-Fi router. And if you're in the same boat, don't worry, because there is a solution. But before we get to that, today's video is brought to you by me and 16-Bit Games. At 16-Bit Games, we offer a wide variety of games available for free on both Android and on iOS. So if you have the chance, please check out our games and play them today. Now, the reason the PlayStation Portable won't connect to a modern Wi-Fi router is because of advancements in Wi-Fi security. You see, the PSP only supports two Wi-Fi security protocols, WEP and WPA. At the time, this covered most of the bases. But nowadays, modern Wi-Fi routers supports more advanced Wi-Fi security protocols like WPA 2 and 3. And since most, if not all, new devices support at least WPA 2, it is typically set as the default security protocol on Wi-Fi routers. So, in order to get your PlayStation Portable online again, the solution is surprisingly easy. Switch your router's security protocol from the secure and safe WPA 2 or 3 to the less secure and vulnerable WPA or WEP. And if that doesn't sound like a good idea to you, it's because this is not. But there are ways you can make this a little safer for your home network if you're adamant on getting your PlayStation Portable online. The first thing you can do is see if your Wi-Fi router supports what's called Yes Wi-Fi, as this allows your primary Wi-Fi to retain its higher security, but also allows your PSP to still access the internet. Your PSP won't be able to talk to other devices on your primary Wi-Fi, but I'm going to be blunt, there's really not a lot you can do with a PSP and other local devices. Or, if you do not have Yes Wi-Fi, you can use what's known as a mix mode. It's usually shown as WPA-WPA2. This will allow devices that have WPA2's security protocols built in to connect with the more secure protocol. But it also allows your PSP, which has WPA on it, to access the internet. But now that your PSP can connect online, let's see what you can actually still do with it. And unfortunately, it's not a lot, at least compared to what it used to be. The PlayStation Store has officially been discontinued for ages, and all you can actually do with it now is just download your games you already acquired. You can do the same thing with a PlayStation 3. The web browser is exactly as I remember it, but since the security tokens expired quite some time ago, most websites won't work anymore, or just flat out refuse to connect, which means that some services like RSS won't work too. And if you were really excited to play Star Wars Battlefront or something equivalent to that, most, if not all, PSP games that had online support are either dead or the services that ran underneath it no longer work. And if you were fortunate enough and actually had a PlayStation Portable with a mic like the 3000 or the Go, you will find that you won't be able to make any more calls with Skype. Weirdly, the only online application on the PSP which seems to still work after all these years is the online radio. But even here, in order to actually install it, you have to have a computer to put the files in the right location. So, in conclusion then, if you reduce your Wi-Fi security protocol to WPA or WEP, you can connect your PSP to the internet. But the only thing you can actually do online is download your old games and listen to some radio. And on that disappointment, it's time to end. Thank you very much for watching, and take care.